disappointing. Okay? Let's put his picture up full mass. When I heard this story, I said, no way. No way. Let me hear the audio. Then I heard the audio. You're looking at Mayor Stephen Reed. Mayor Stephen Reed is the mayor of Montgomery. Here's what he said according to a recording.
Don't ask now. I can come smile. I don't have to do no goddamn work. Okay? I don't have to do no work systemically, and I'm gonna be fine. And guess what? I will always get 38 to 45% of the white vote. If I get 30 to 45% of the white vote, I can have them get the black vote I got this past election.
You got black city, that's great. You can have all black everything. And guess what? You won't have green nothing.
Yeah, white money thinks that you are looking after them. They will take their crack bill, they will take the pipe road, and you won't.
Now, I want you to decide if his explanation is fitting. It is not fitting for me personally. I'm disappointed in the statements. They do not affix to the policy positions he ran on. They are contrary to what we understand as good progressive movement. All right. There's more audio. Let me go ahead and read this. It was obtained by 1819 News. It says, you think MFers around here gonna invest in Montgomery? Reed asks rhetorically. You think I expect the descendants of Confederate soldiers effing investing in Montgomery? Question mark. Beyond what's good for them? Question mark. They give you some charity. They give you some charity. They give you something nice over Valiant Cross where I'm on the board. But will they really invest in systemic change? Hell, effing no. They're not going to invest in it. So don't ever mix up what I'm doing. You haven't seen a scientist as diabolical as me, because no one has come into this what I have. There's an audio. There's an audio clip that features me speaking privately with a member. This is what he's saying, with a member of the Montgomery community. Okay. This clip has been heavily edited and features carefully selected sound bites of my voice. The conversation was recorded without my knowledge or consent by this community member almost 3 years ago. All right. So this is his statement. Now, like I said, I'm disappointed in these statements holistically. All right. When he's talking about black voters and basically doesn't need them because he's going to get a certain amount of white votes. You're sounding like, sir, the person who had the job before you, or the people who had the job before you. You have to understand, people are going to get upset when you have a position that is now contrary to that which has been produced by recording. The folks who trust you, sir, deserve a direct explanation. There's more of the statement. It reads, the meeting with this community member was prompted by our concerns about civil unrest in the immediate aftermath of the death of George Floyd. During this meeting, it became abundantly clear to me that this individual sought personal financial gain during a time of crisis in our city, state, and country. You have my word that no one in my administration will ever give in to a shakedown or extortion. The mission of our administration is to bring more opportunity to each and every resident while making sure that Montgomery's success is their success. As mayor, I will continue working tirelessly for our citizens and not let distractions keep us from doing the business of the day. Mr. Mayor, it is a distraction, but it's one that you created. A distraction that you did. At some point, you have to take full responsibility for the actual statement. And yes, it was said not out of wisdom. It sounded as if it was out of anger, and some other stuff happened with you, dear brother. I really hope you become, obviously, the advocate that many of my friends believe you are. This statement in response to that tape is damning. But I will say this, if your proclamation is true, sue them. They lied on you, sir. Sue them. Depose them. Make them tell the truth under oath. Because you know who did the recording. Sue them. You have not only the authority, you have the resource. Jeff, thoughts here?
Well, Dr. Richey, as you just stated, you have people who know him or know of him. And so they are looking to his character to see what he might do in a positive sense moving forward. I don't know this man, but based off that statement of a diabolical, what did he say, diabolical evil? This is this man's villain arc. Like, to me, he's Lex Luthor. And this man's math is not mathing when it comes to percentage of the racial makeup of Montgomery. He does need the black vote, but apparently he doesn't care about black or white, just as long as green is involved. Mm. And my word, as you just said, Dr. Richey, he does know the community member, but he said the community member was seeking financial gain. No, brother, you are seeking financial gain by what you just said about the people, the white people who make up your community. That's what you're trying to do. So I don't know you, and maybe, you know, sue the person who has alleged you said these things. But if not, man, you're a villain. That's just who you are, just like the people who came before you.
Listen, I'm going to give the guy an opportunity. I extend an invitation, Mr. Mayor, to come on the program, come on the bullpen, explain your position, your proclamation. Open invitation for the entire year, all right?